Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da, habibillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and bless you. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this sitting or your listening to be a gathering of dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. Be reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your right and the haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over you, which is to worship Him and Him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah put it on the scale of our good deeds and not the scale of our evil deeds. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika and ushrika bika wa ana a'lamu wa astaghfiruka lima la a'lamu. Listen to this hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi, which shows us that Islam encourages us that from the rights of Islam is that we're even kind towards the animals. And that when you see, and unfortunately, and I'm going to mention this, I've seen this in many of the Muslim lands, the way that people treat the animals. For example, here they abandon their cats. They buy cats, very expensive cats, and when they get a little older, they just let the cats go out on the street because their children are tired of them, and they just let them become cats to try to hunt rats and live in the streets. You'll find many beautiful Persian cats in the street, littered throughout the society. Likewise, you'll find people who torment animals, and I've seen this countless times, especially in Yemen, where they stone the puppies and they stone the animals. But this is not from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. This is not from the khair of Islam. This is not from those things which will get you to Jannah. But in fact, it could be one of the means to get you into the nar, into the hellfire. So give everyone their due rights, and even the animals, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation, should be respected and not tormented and not harmed in the least. Listen to this hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. An Abi Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qal anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal baynama rajulun yamshi bit-tariq ashtadda alayhi al-atash fawajida بئر فنزل فيها فشرب ثم خرج فإذا قلب يلهث يأكل ثراء من العطش فقال الرجل لقد بلغ هذا القلب من العطش مثل الذي كان قد بلغ مني فنزل البئر فملأ خفه ماء ثم أمسكه بفكيه حتى رقي فسقي القلب فشكر الله له فغفر له قالوا يا رسول الله وإن لنا في بهائم أجر فقال في كل كبد رتبتي أجر رواه بخاري ومسلم اللفظ للبخاري وفي رواية للبخاري فشكر الله له فغفر له فأدخله الجنة. In this hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, again, as we mentioned, it shows the importance of being kind even to animals, and that when you see animals that are being tormented or that they are in need, then fulfill their needs as you would fulfill the needs of a person. Try to assist them if you are able to do so. In this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man, it was reported on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu that he said, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, while a man was walking along a road, he became very thirsty. On finding a well, he descended into it and drank. Then he saw a dog with his tongue hanging out, trying to lick up mud in order to quench its thirst. The man said to himself, the same thirst which afflicted me has also afflicted this dog. So he descended into to the well once more and filled his leather sock with water. Then holding it in his teeth, he ascended and gave the dog a drink. Allah appreciated this act of his and forgave his sins. They, the companions, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, asked, "Is there then a reward for us in being kind to animals, O Messenger of Allah?" Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He replied, "In kindness to everything, there is reward." Bukhari and Muslim. And this is the wording of Al-Bukhari. In another narration, Al-Bukhari stated, it is stated, Allah appreciated this act of his and forgave his sins and admitted him into paradise. So from this hadith, we see that even small kindnesses, we should never underestimate them. Al-Ma'un, that small kindness can be a means for you to get to Jannah and a saving from the hellfire. This hadith also illustrates the virtue of showing kindness to all living creatures, and that your kindnesses are rewarded by Allah Azza wa Jal. Also, this hadith shows us that by being kind to living creatures, any living creatures, the animals, the insects even, that this could be something where you're rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this. So it shows the mercy and rahmah of Islam, and that the mu'min exemplifies that mercy and rahmah. Another benefit of this hadith is that a person may be admitted to paradise because of such a small kindness. And likewise, this hadith illustrates for us how the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, were also vigilant in asking about Islamic knowledge. They wanted to know, they wanted ilm, because they wanted to know and do those things which would bring them closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.